Here we are working through another question on the certified Q&A for the Google Cloud Platform Associate Cloud Engineer. It's very important to the process of understanding Google Cloud and passing the certification exam that you go through the question and attempt answering it yourself first. So pause the video, work through the question. We'll catch up in just a little while and I'll show you how I do it. You have created a Kubernetes deployment called Deployment A with three replicas on your cluster. Another deployment called Deployment B needs access to Deployment A. You cannot expose Deployment A outside of the cluster. What should you do? The key parts of this question are, of course, that it's a Kubernetes deployment and that you want to keep Deployment A private within the cluster and you don't want to expose it outside. Before we look at the answer options, let's look at the general architecture of Kubernetes. So as part of the entire cluster, there is going to be the part managed by GKE, which is the master. And then there are the nodes, which contain the pods, which will have your application. These nodes will be given IP addresses, and they will also have some open ports. When you define a service, there are two levels at which you need to look at this. There's a logical level, and there's a physical level. At the physical level are all the machines, the VMs that you have provisioned. And within those VMs, you will have specific containers. And those containers will have the apps that you've deployed. At a logical level, there are, say, services. Services are spread across all these pods, or they could be spread across all these pods, but they have one central definition somewhere within the master itself. So when trying to access a service, remember that even though you access it at a single point, it could be distributed across multiple nodes. When a user accesses a service now, it is going to direct that request to one of the nodes. Now, you could either access service directly and have it be routed, or because you also could have an access to the IP address of the node, you could potentially go that way too. With that understanding, let's now look at Alice's suggestion. She suggests that we create a service of type NodePort for the new deployment A, and we create an ingress resource for that service. How does NodePort work? When you declare a service as NodePort, one, we can only use a high value port. In this case, we're using 30,000 and 30,001 to declare the two services, service one and service two. The service one, which is in green, is spread across node one and node two. Node one has the IP address 10.0.0.1 and node two has 10.0.0.2. The services are in pods. There are a couple of copies within 10.0.0.1 and there is one copy of service one in 10.0.0.2. And vice versa for service 2. In a NodePort service, what happens is that for each of the ports for which there is a service defined, those ports are opened on all of the nodes. So in this particular case, we have service 1 with a NodePort of 30,000 and service 2 with a NodePort of 30,001. So Kubernetes will now open those ports 30,000 and 30,001 on all available nodes in which for us, which is 10.0.0.1 and 10.0.0.2. So now a user trying to access a service could directly go to the node, say the address 10.0.0.1 or 10.0.0.2, and then try to access the service at that port. Because both of them could potentially have the service and the ports are anyway open. So on the right-hand side, we are trying to access 10.0.0.1:30,000, 10.0.0.1:30,001, similarly 10.0.0.2:30,000 and 10.0.0.2:30,001, all of them are accessible to the user. Note here that the user is external to the cluster in this case. One interesting aspect of the NodePort is that even if a particular service is not on a node, in this case, service 2 is not on node 1, which is at 10.0.0.1. But if we try to access that service, 10.0.0.1:30001, remember that service 2 is running at 30001, but we try to access it via node 1, even though node 1 itself does not have the service, it is able to redirect that request to node 2, which has that service. So NodePort service will automatically handle that. Even in this case, remember that the access is allowed from outside the cluster. So NodePort in general exposes the service externally, and that is not suitable for our requirement that we cannot expose deployment A outside the cluster. How about Bob's suggestion that we create a service of type load balancer for deployment A, and then have deployment B use that service IP address? What is the difference between a node port and a load balancer? In the case of a node port, that port is directly open and accessible via the node's IP address. Whereas in the case of a load balancer, we are going to access it at a single point. So there is going to be a single IP address with that port number, and a request to that service, in this case, say service 1:8080, is going to be routed to any of the nodes that contain that service. In this particular case, the service could be routed to 10.0.0.1 or 10.0.0.2 because both have the service available. Even in this case, note that the user is able to access service from outside the cluster. Therefore, using a load balancer also does not suit a requirement because that service is exposed outside. How about option C, that we create a service of type load balancer for deployment A and an ingress resource for that service, and have deployment B use an ingress IP address? We've already ruled out using load balancer because it exposes outside. Even so, just for the learning, let's figure out what an ingress resource is. The difference between a load balancer and an ingress is that the load balancer requires a separate IP address for each of the services. Whereas for an ingress, it is possible to have a single IP and then route the request to different pods and nodes depending on, say, the URL or the subdomain. So for an ingress, you only need one IP, whereas in the case of a load balancer, you might have multiple IPs corresponding to each service that you have. Because this option also uses a load balancer, and load balancer and ingress, they both support exposing the service outside, this is not a suitable option. Now, how about Dave's suggestion that we create a service of type ClusterIP? Unlike the others, a ClusterIP is internal to the cluster, and users within the cluster are able to access any service, whereas any user outside the cluster is not allowed any access of the service. This suits our requirement perfectly, and therefore Dave's suggestion that we use a cluster IP is the one that we are going to use for this project requirement. Let us just confirm that option D is the correct answer by looking at the docs. The doc says that cluster IP exposes service on a cluster internal IP. Choosing this value makes the service only reachable from within the cluster. When nothing else is specified, this is going to be the default service type. Perfect, that suits us, and therefore ClusterIP is the right option to have chosen. What are the key learnings from this question? You have to know Kubernetes at a basic to intermediate level. You have to know the different kinds of services and the differences between them. You also have to know how to provision nodes and then set up the services on these. Also know the difference between gcloud and kubectl and which one you use under which circumstance. I'll leave you a couple of references on how to publish services, the different kinds of services, and a nice article on the difference between NodePort, Load Balancer, and Ingress. Well, how are you going to inform others of the super GCP content? Just one way, like it, share it, let them get to know of it, and you subscribe.